guys, welcome back to my channel. First of all, let me just start by saying thank you to everyone who has viewed and left positive comments on my day in the life of a software engineer video. I was not expecting even 1,000 view in that, and now right now it sits on around 80k, which is crazy. So I got a lot of questions also in that video, and I thought I would address to some of the most asked questions. So yeah, let's just start the video. So the first question was that which company do I work in, my graduation detail and my tech detail. So for that, guys, you can just directly go to the LinkedIn profile. I have linked it down below on the description box. So this will save a lot of time. You can just go visit that and get to know about all those details. Second was, a lot of people asked me why my screen was blurred and that they wanted to see me code. So guys, that is actually not possible, because when we join a company as an employee, we are supposed to sign a non-disclosure agreement. So what that basically means is we cannot show or discuss or, you know, tell anyone what we are working on or like our screen in any sort of way. So if you'll go and search more videos of a day in a life, so you will realize that everyone does it. So I cannot show it, so I'm sorry for that. The third question and the most important question, I think this a lot of people want to know, is what do I do as a software engineer? So the world of software engineering is very wide, and there are so many things to do, and every engineer does very different job. So do not consider what I do as like the base and think everyone else does the same. I will just describe you what I do. So till now I have worked in enhancement projects. So what that means is, we already have a made project, and then if our client gives us a new requirement, for example, if the owner of my project says that they are not happy or they want one feature to be updated because they think it is outdated and they want something to be changed. So we get that requirement and then we start working on it. So to give you more insight, I'll say that, for example, my client would see that the security systems in his application is very outdated. So he would just come to us and say, you know, can you make this more updated? And this is now a requirement, updation of the security system. And now my team would firstly analyze and, you know, find out how can we achieve it, if we can achieve it, and what are the different ways through which we can update it. And then we see that how many days will it require for us to complete this requirement. So all these things are done, and then we send this data to our client, and then if everything is settled, we start working on the requirement. So now when the requirement comes, we break it down to a lot of tasks. So there can be like, we have to remove the old code, then we have to put a new code, and like many small tasks. And every person in the project will get one task each. And every person in the team will then also give how many days will it require for that person to complete that task. For example, if I am given the task of taking out the old code, I would just say that, you know, like I will require 5 days for this. And similarly, the other team members will tell the lead that how many days will they take, how many efforts will it require. And we set a goal that this requirement we will finish in 1 month, 2 months, or whatever it is. And we start analyzing our tasks. Then we start coding for it. And once it is coded, we do a unit testing. Unit testing is, if I make a change, I will do a small test if it is not affecting any other code, because a project can be huge and even a small change can actually cause a ripple effect. So we do a small unit test if it is working fine with the other already existing functionalities. And once the unit testing is done, we do an integration test, which would be that all the other people are also working on their tasks, right? So all these tasks, all the code changes will be then merged into one place, and then we'll see if, you know, all this code is working fine together. Then there is a QA test, which is like a different team. So the QA is a testing team. So they do a small test and then it is pushed to production. and production is where the real code works. So on the day our main code is pushed to production, that day we will also provide support, because you know, in case even after all the testing the code is not working on, you know, the production, it could be a huge problem because people are using that app in real time. So at that time, for some time, we have to stay online and give production support. So that's what I have done till now in my over 3 years of experience. So this is not how it works all the time. There are a lot of layers to it. Sometimes we give a requirement. We say, you know, your application is getting outdated at the front end side. You should change the UI language or something like that. And then we tell our client and the client approves it or rejects it. So also, you don't have to work alone. You, when your task is assigned, it is not like if my task is there, no one else can work in it. That's not how it is. So I think IT industry is very nice like that. You don't have to, you know, you don't ever feel like you're alone, because there are your seniors and then you have your juniors, and actually so many people you can reach out to. It's up to you. You can ask anyone who you think is more expert in that topic. And I have never come across, you know, people who would say no. They'll always help you. So I think there's nothing, if this scares you, then I will tell you that this is not scary at all. You can always ask your seniors or even your juniors. And as I already said, this is not how every software engineer works. It will differ based on the years of experience you have, what technology you work, and what kind of company you work for. So there are a lot of factors. Do not think that this is how it is for everyone. The fourth most asked question, which is like also the last question that I'm going to cover here, is a lot of people were impressed with the work-life balance. And I had already mentioned it a lot of times in the video that it was because I was new and I didn't have a project back then. I was getting onboarded. I was just completing the trainings that I was assigned. So that's why I logged out at 6:45, and my login also was so late. It was just that. But even after I logged out, I did stay online using my phone. So yeah, my work hours are still 9 hours and 15 minutes. So to this also, a lot of people had questions like, why weren't you assigned any tasks yet? Because it has already been like more than a month. So the answer to this will first need an explanation, that there are a lot of different kind of companies in the IT industry. You have a product based company, and then you have a service based company, and then there are startups. So if you are going to work for a product based company, so which is, they make their own products, say they have their own, maybe IT related, maybe software related, maybe not, but they have their own products to sell and that people use. Service based companies are those which provide their services. This can be support services, enhancement services, or just making projects from scratch for other companies, for the product based companies. And the startups are small new companies. So when you join a product company, it doesn't take much time. Why? Because you will be having project within this company, and you, as soon as you join, you can start working at any of the projects that you're assigned. I don't think startup companies even hire without first knowing that what you are going to do. So they have their budget very set, and so they know even before they are interviewing you that what job you would be assigned. For service-based company, this is not how it happens. First, you join a service-based company, and this company will have a lot of projects for a lot of different clients under them, and you will be aligned to one of these projects. And for this, you'll have to first give one internal interview, which your service-based company will take. And then they will assign you to different clients, and then you'll have a client interview internally. So this all is happening internally. Okay. And once you complete this client interview, the whole onboarding process is again started for you, because for that company, for your client, you're a new candidate. So they will make a new ID for you. They will go through a new background verification process altogether for you. So this takes a lot of time. So this is a huge series of, you know, tasks that happen as soon as you join a service company. And I have joined a service company, and this is the reason that it took so long, because I was going through a lot of processes at that time, and when I made that video, I was getting onboarded and did not have any project related tasks. I will make one updated video once I get into the project, so stay tuned for that. So now a lot of people were saying they want this work-life balance. Well guys, service-based company does provide you a good work-life balance, but like that's not the case every time. So as I said, I was being onboarded at that time, so that's why the tasks were less. Some people, even after the projects are assigned, have a good, like, okay work-life balance, and some people can have it bad also in service-based companies. So this is not like a hard and fast rule that service companies will have always great work-life balance, but yeah, it'll always be better than joining a startup. So it's completely up to you, which company do you want to work for. As I said, product, service, startup, and you, all of them have their own advantages and disadvantages. If you join a product-based company, you would be working on good projects with good money, and you will have like this brand name, a good brand name that you work here, right? Oh, everyone loves to hear that someone is working in Amazon or Google and all these companies that are product-based companies. And for startup companies, join if you want to not limit yourself just to coding. You want yourself to be aligned to management side and, you know, interaction with the client, because at startup level, because the company is so small that you could be interacting directly with the client. So if you do not want to limit yourself just to coding, go for startups, but keep in mind that the work-life balance is not that great. I mean, it's difficult honestly to handle a startup job. And for service-based company, you will have a good work-life balance and you will have projects, but they won't be as good as a product-based company or a startup company's project, and the salary will also be not that great as you are going to be, you know, offered in a product-based company. So it's a choice that you make. I am happy with my choices because I wanted some time to explore my creative side, and that's the reason that right now I'm in a service-based company. But guys, you can get into any company that you want. It does not matter how much you scored in your IIT JEE. If you want to get into Amazon, you will get into Amazon. Do not let any hotshot engineer working in a huge product-based company or a huge company tell you that you cannot, because you can. You can get, you can go anywhere you want. You can start working right now and set an aim for yourself and then start working for it. I'm saying this because I got a nasty comment from someone from Amazon. So yeah, this is the choice that I made to be working here, and I'm happy with it for now. So yeah, I hope that this helps. Please leave your questions down below, and I will try to make one more video just like this to cover the remaining topics. And also guys, I am not like a career guru, so when you ask me questions like should I go for MBA or MS or MTech, like I seriously do not know how to answer that. I can research for you and get back to you, but please do not get super mad if I do not answer it correctly. Yeah, that's all I wanted to cover for today. I hope you got something out of this video, and yeah, I'll see you next time. Till then, bye, take care. Da 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 da.